Brooklyn Independent Television.
Welcome to another episode of BK4Reel. I'm Kareem from Real Works Team Filmmaking, and I'm here at Brick Studio, downtown Brooklyn, where last week, Melvin Van Peebles took the stage to speak about one of his newer projects. We have a great show up for you today. We're going to give you a behind-the-scenes look at a program called Young Audiences New York from International Arts and Business High School in Brooklyn.
What I like so much about it is the fact that it doesn't hide who you are as a person. That's what I love about it. When I'm standing outside, I'm looking outside, I see all these people passing me by, and I'm looking into each and every one of their faces, and I know that each of them have a story to tell. But they're just too afraid to say it. They're too afraid to express themselves. I think film really gives you that kind of je ne sais quoi, that thing that makes you want to just go out there and shoot whatever it is that's on your mind. Shoot whatever it is that you see and try to fit the pieces together. Those who love film should just go for it. Even if they say it's stupid, it's not a good career, you're not going to make any money out of it, keep going, keep trying. This is my moment, this is my time to show them what I've got and what I can work with.
The easiest way to put it is that basically with young audiences, we integrate the arts into the current curriculum of classes at the International Art and Business School. So for instance, if there's a government class, we might work with them to create a film about the history of government, or we might analyze propaganda through media. Veronica Morgan did a documentary about her mother who passed away from complications with HIV. And another was Azam Innes, who did a documentary about his friend who was competing in the Golden Globes. In some ways, working with them independently helped me as a filmmaker. It really does inspire you on a daily basis.
Mother, she is my voice to speak, my eyes to see, my feet to walk.
Some of my friends was crying, and some of my friends couldn't believe that I did it. Some of my friends couldn't imagine me doing something like that. And like they came to me like, oh, you're a strong person for what you did.
How do you feel when you find out that she was sick?
I can't tell you that, Veronica, I didn't know.
I guess a weight lifted off of me. I guess because I felt like people didn't know who she was, so it's like for me to make that movie, I felt like people know who the real person she is, that how I know her.
And the residency I had with Ms. McCallum, the students wrote very personal stories. They wrote, there was a story about dating violence. There was a story about a pregnancy scare.
How come you didn't call me back last night? I was coming.
Well, me and Kadeem, you know, we were like, what y'all was doing? I hope you use protection.
Yeah, of course, but anyways, you know, after last time, you know what happened.
There were these very dramatic, short little 5-page scripts, and then we went over the fundamentals of, you know, basic filmmaking as far as like framing and lighting and acting and blocking. And then as a class, we shot those scripts and created the High School Moments trilogy.
Look at me now. One baby on the way, the other screaming, crying for her father. I thought this was going to be a fairy tale.
It really gives people the opportunity to like really like just have fun and like express what they're feeling and share things and be creative, because there are a lot of minds in here that's very creative.
We had one film that was just a snap camera animation with a girl just like driving her desk around the room. The student filming it was this girl, Carlene Lexador. And after like 5 minutes of explaining the fundamentals of stop camera animation, you know, she was just like, all right, I got it. And she kind of like kicked me out of the room. And when I saw what she had done, she had all these different angles and all these different shots. And it was really impressive.
What's going in my head when I'm shooting is, just catch, like, keeping every moment. Every moment, keeping it. You know, once it's on camera, it's there. It's like memory you could always look back on. That's what I love about cameras.
Just to give you an idea, here's this family who had a two-story house. They were stubborn and they wanted to stay behind. And just to give you an idea of how high the water was, they had to be rescued by a boat from the second floor.
So. And that was one of the most amazing experiences of my life, like seeing different people, like a different culture, right in America, like right in our own home, you know.
The couches are still there, fridges on the roof. How you?
Pretty much just documented everything we seen. Every night out, every day we went to work, you know.
It's my view of things. It's what I think, it's what's in my head. So like when it changed colors, stops on her, change colors. But when it resumes, it was like she's already back in up.
Flashes, goes to black and white, and then pops back and we're there. Is that what you're saying?
Yeah. Like you could write things down, what's on your mind, but you can't really show it. You leave things to the imagination. I don't want that. I want them to know exactly what I'm thinking about. And that's what I love about video.
Okay. I'm excited about Sherlock Holmes, though. It's going to be good. It's fun.
Scénario de François Truffaut.
Brooklyn Independent Television on the BCAT TV Network.